You say no. You say the leak was totally wrong.
I do, Brooke, and I have been full-throated in my defense of this FBI director on CNN. I have lauded his actions. I've certainly lauded his character. I've defended the decision-making process, and good and decent folks on both sides of the issue can come down and have a strong argument either way. Where I think the FBI director lost the moral high ground yesterday, after he gave such an impassioned opening statement and literally had most of us, I was choked up listening to him defend the institution, the apolitical nature of the FBI, and defending us, those still on the job and those like me who are retired. He lost the moral high ground because a leak is such a benign term. It is the unauthorized disclosure of classified information. And I know I'm certainly not going to argue legal aspects with Mark. He knows the law far better than I do. Mm-hmm. But there are processes and protocols in place. I'm retired from the FBI. If I elect to write a book, I have to get the Department of Justice to sign off on my own intellectual property. What the FBI director did was take a document and the ideas that were contained within those four corners, and he didn't even go to the New York Times himself. He shared it with a surrogate. I don't understand it. I don't understand why he claimed that there were various reasons why not. I'm sure there are personal reasons, but to me, it diminished a man who 99.9% of America looked at and said, whether we agree with his actions or not, he's an honest, decent, moral man, and we're not questioning his character or his words.
But, okay, I'm just trying to understand the full picture. And so on the legality of this, let me, Mark, pose this to you. I mean, at this point, he's a private citizen. You know, yes, he could have, you know, walked over to the press who was camped out in his driveway, as he discussed yesterday morning, but he gave it to his friend who ultimately leaked it to the New York Times. Does it matter? You know, he said it wasn't a classified memo. He's a private citizen. Is that, you know, I know you're saying it's not wrong, but the fact that he's a private citizen, does that matter, Mark?
Yes, it matters because if he was still employed at the Department of Justice, they would be able, if they actually wanted to do something to him that would have teeth in it. It is, and as long as we're assuming there's no classified information, it's not a violation of whatever the code section is, 641. But the fact remains that if he leaked that information and it was privileged or he did not have permission at that point, then there's an ethical issue. I don't disagree that he loses the moral high ground, but that's a different question than, number one, is it illegal? Number two, is it unethical?
But
moral high ground is something else.
Is that not, you know, wanting to influence the